though, what I'm doing today is a she devil. Now, I got inspired by this page on YouTube. I can't even remember it right now. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna leave it in the description box. What I'm doing now here is protecting my hair with Vaseline because we're gonna be using latex. And I already put the contacts in because I'm supposed to be a devil and this is supposed to be red. So yeah. All right, let's get started. I think I'm gonna now switch over to a voiceover because there's going to be a lot of talking. Hey guys, so again, please make sure you like and subscribe to my channel and please turn on your notifications so you can know when I upload, okay? So all I'm doing right now is just pulling back my hair so I can put the ball cap on. And it actually secured really easily, so that was like a plus. I didn't even need to use latex, but it's best to use latex just to be certain that everything is going to stay. So I'm just dabbing some latex on the sponge and then I'm putting it on the perimeter of the ball cap and like on my forehead area. And I'm also putting some in the inside by the air, like that tab by the air, yeah. So you can just make sure it lays down flat and like it sticks. I let the latex dry for about 10 minutes and then I apply the paint. As you can see, I'm doing fair. It is absolutely necessary to do a couple of coats. I did, I think, 3 or 4. You need to do it because the color doesn't show up on the first layer. So the more layers you have, the better the pigment will show. I don't know about y'all, but it's something so fascinating about watching videos that dub speak for me. Like, I love it. It's just so relaxing. Kind of like an ASMR. I'm not sure. Would this be considered an ASMR, Loki? Anyways, so I'm just gonna let that dry, and then after that, bam! 4 layers. That's 4 layers, guys. So you see why you need to do like 3 or 4 coats? Cool. So now I'm just taking some latex. And, I gotta talk to you guys about this prosthetic. I made these prosthetics myself. And guys, I would leave the video that I watched to do so in the description box. It was a very easy video to follow. However, these prosthetics did not just take 10 minutes. They took me about 24 hours. I got frustrated. I stopped. As in, took a break. I didn't quit. And I'm so happy with the way they turned out. And I realized that I have a new talent and skill. Guys, if you want to see how I actually made these prosthetics, then please let me know by commenting and saying, girl, show us how you did them. Because I had a couple of friends that said, did you record this part? And I'm just like, no, I didn't record it because it took a very long time. But if you want to see, I will be happy to do another FX look like this. So now I'm just adding the other prosthetic. I have about like 4 pieces that I made. To adhere them to my skin, all I'm doing is using the latex again, and I'm just letting it, pressing it down, I should say, on my skin for about a minute or so until they can stick on their own. And it's very easy to get them to stick on their own. They dry quick and everything like that. So you should have no problem with this. So now I'm adding the cheekbones, and I will say that was probably the hardest prosthetic piece to make for me. For some reason, I just couldn't get the shape right. Like, you're gonna see my left side and then my right side looks completely different from each other. But you know what? It worked out fine and it got the job done. So after the prosthetic dried, I began to paint my face, and I started off with a cream-based paint for my skin just because I'm of darker complexion and I wanted to make sure that there was no reason it wasn't going to match. After I finished painting my entire face, that's when I went back in with the water-based paint, which was what I used originally for the cap.
I was really getting nervous at this point because, like, it wasn't matching at all. Clearly, my skin is darker and the prosthetics are, like, light. So it just looked crazy in the beginning. But this is really when you have to trust the process and, like, just have good faith that everything will work out perfectly fine. And it did. So just trust the process, guys. So now I'm going back in, and this is with the watercolored paint, and you can see for sure how the pigment just like completely started to change, and this is what I was hoping for. If I had originally started with the water paint, it was not going to come off or show up like this. But because I started with the cream paint and then went in with the water paint for the second layer, this is how I got the color to look like this, and I'm very happy with the way it turned out. I made sure I kept around the eyes cleared for highlights and dimension because, you know, everyone has different tones in their skin, and it would be the same for creatures and characters of such. So then I began to add areas of shadow in all the spots I missed with the big brush. And I also made some grooves in the prosthetic, and those were definite areas of shadows, but also just some random spots. I just put areas of shadow there to add more personality and give it some more like definition or dimension. So this right here was a little fail, but I fixed it. I started off with the water paint when I knew that I should have started off with the cream paint, like how I did with my base, the skin. And it definitely was not showing up, which is what I thought would happen. But then I went back with the cream, and as you can see, it began to show up on my skin. So, easy fix. So now I'm just adding some black on top of that to give her more of like an evil kind of look, or make her a little bit more dark, because she was looking a little too nice, you know? I want her to be cute, but definitely, definitely scary. Just going in and adding a little bit more yellow because I thought I needed some more. And I also think I went in and blended a little bit more so it can be like a gradient effect from the red to the yellow. Just adding a little bit more contour or like dimension to the cheek area, which is where you would normally add like the contour, so it made a lot of sense. And again, all the grooves and things that I added while I made the prosthetics needed to be colored in, so that's where it is. Because my face had all this texture and highlight and contour to it, I felt it was necessary to add some texture to the ball cap as well. So I'm taking some of that contour color and just adding it to the top because I felt like that would give it a little bit more texture. Now I'm just adding some detail to make her a little bit more feminine, and these are supposed to be her lashes, but I'm also going to be adding some false lashes too to exaggerate and enhance the look. This was probably my favorite part. I enjoyed putting on the lipstick so much. I felt like it just tied the whole thing together because I did love how it was coming out, but this just made me fall like deeply in love with it. I was like, oh my gosh, this looks so good. So I'm completely done with the face and now I'm just moving down to the body. I'm going to cover my entire upper body in paint. And of course, I'm going to do it in layers, and I think I did about 3 or 4 layers of this. Missed the highlight point on my face, so I'm just going back in and getting that together. That's about it. After about 3 layers of paint, I am just going in and adding some highlight points on my neck area and on my chest. And we are pretty much done with the entire look. You can actually go a little step further, which is what I did, and I added some paint to my hands, as you see right there. It was a bit messy and it got everywhere, so that is completely optional and up to you. You can see by my face that I thought it was so gross, but guys, if it's one thing you should know about me, I commit. I commit fully. Ah! Okay, I'm sorry, I just had to do that. Well, anyways, guys, this is the finished product. I am loving how it came out. Please, if you are loving this too, like, comment, and subscribe to my channel. I am looking forward to making more videos. And thank you guys for the support. Bye.